That concludes the debate on active ventilation in schools. It is now time to move on to the next item of business, which is point of order, Michael Mara.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I rise to make a point in order to seek your guidance on any potential mechanism to question the Government on an issue of great urgency in relation to the vaccination programme. As members will be aware, the JCVI yesterday changed the guidance in relation to booster vaccinations from 6 months to 3, with the First Minister reiterating the importance of receiving the vaccine and the boosters. I've been contacted by several people who therefore became eligible for the booster and were able to book online to receive it, who were then turned away at the vaccination centre. This simply means wasted slots, wasted shots, and that we will have to hope that those taking time to be turned away decide to return. There is a fundamental, Presiding Officer, and dangerous mismatch between what the public are being told by ministers and the reality on the ground. This must be rectified immediately, and we need a strong statement from the Government so that people can have confidence that the vaccination programme is open to them and can be delivered, particularly given the uncertainty the Omicron variant has brought.
Thank you, Mr Mara. I would suggest, Mr Mara, that you use the usual mechanisms to put questions to Government. There are several mechanisms, including urgent questions through FMQs, supplementary questions and the like. Mr Mara will be aware of these mechanisms. Thank you. The next item of business is consideration of motion 2307 in the name of Mary McCallan on the reappointment of Scottish Land Commissioners. And I call on Mary McCallan to move the motion.
Thanks, Presiding Officer. Very briefly, I'm pleased to move this motion, which recognises the Net Zero Energy and Transport Committee's consideration of the reappointment of Andrew Thin as Chair of the Scottish Land Commission and two of the Land Commissioners, Dr Sally Reynolds and Lauren McLeod. They are reappointed alongside Dr Bob McIntosh, who plays a vital role in supporting our tenant farming sector. I'd like to thank all the reappointees for their work to date, and I look forward to working with them in the coming years to deliver Scotland's ambitious land reform agenda.
Thank you, and I call Rachel Hamilton.
Presiding Officer, public bodies are responsible for around £17 billion of public spending, and therefore it is important that we get public appointments right. I neither speak for or against the motion today. I rise to share my concerns regarding the reappointment of four Scottish Land Commissioners. Whilst I acknowledge that the Net Zero Committee recommended approval of the reappointments, I want to remind members that the role of the Land Commission is to stimulate fresh thinking and change how we, as a nation, own and use land. Fresh thinking and attracting a new pool of talent on boards in Scotland is lacking. Stephen Boyle, Auditor General for Scotland, said in July 2021, "I referred to our audit work and evidence which confirms that board members have a strong bearing on the effectiveness of the governance of public bodies and organisational performance. I also highlighted the issue of equality and diversity, and that in my view, wider representation on boards should help progress towards a fairer and more equal society. The Scottish Government should consider that continuity does not bring change and the habitual practice of drawing from the same pool does not send a positive message. It does not attract new and fresh faces. It does not attract applicants from protected groups, including more women, disabled groups, young people and ethnic minorities. Furthermore, public bodies require progressive skills and knowledge to keep pace and technology and deliver on climate change targets. Therefore, I would ask if the Scottish Government believe that culture of continuity is healthy and whether the Minister is confident that these reappointments seek to bring the diverse representation that we seek."
Thank you. The question on this motion will be put at decision time. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 2345 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Moved, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. No member has asked to speak on the motion. The question is that motion 2345 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of business motions 2348 on a Stage 1 timetable for a bill and 2349 on a Stage 2 timetable for a bill. And I ask any member who wishes to speak against the motions to press their request to speak button. Okay. I call on George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move the motions.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm moved.
Thank you, Minister. No member has asked to speak against the motions. Therefore, the question is that motions 2348 and 2349 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motions are therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of four Parliamentary Bureau motions, and I ask George Adam, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, to move motions 2346 and 2347 on approval of SSIs, 2350 on Office of the Clerk, 2351 on suspension and variation of standing orders, and 2352 on committee membership.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and all moved.
Thank you. The question on these motions will be put at decision time. There are seven questions to be put as a result of today's business. The first is that Amendment 2327.2, in the name of Humza Yousaf, which seeks to amend Motion 2327 in the name of Anna Sarwar on protecting patient safety at the Queen Elizabeth University Hospital, be agreed. Are we all agreed? The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we will move to a vote, and there will be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.